Good day and welcome to my new music room. I've been having some back and forth with my friend George over in the UK. Not sure where he's from exactly in the UK, but hey, it's not that big compared to the US anyway. But we've been talking about copyright strikes, and I just thought that I would share my experience with copyright strikes. I don't have this talk prepared, so I might just ramble a whole lot, but I thought it might be helpful just to share what's happened to me. I got my first copyright strike several years ago. I've been recording and uploading to YouTube since March 5th of 2010, I think. And I got my first strike when I had 800 covers on YouTube. Now, that strike was for a song called Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer, which is owned by a man named Elmo Shropshire. And apparently, he is married to a woman named Pam Wendell. And Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer was my most viewed song at the time. It probably had, I don't know, maybe 13,000 views. I don't remember specifically, but I do remember that at one point after I had originally posted the song, I got a comment from, as it turned out, I think it was Pam Wendell, and she said something about the fact that this song was not originally written by Elmo Shropshire. I remember it was recorded by Patsy and Elmo. Well, that was apparently Dr. Shropshire's first wife was Patsy. I believe he is a veterinarian. I may be wrong. Please don't sue me for that. But we had a conversation back and forth about the originality of the song and who wrote it and who first recorded it. Well, many, many months later, after this song had been on YouTube for over a year, and as I said, it was my most viewed song, I get a copyright strike. So I was able to reconnect with Pam Wendell, and I went emailed back and forth a couple of times, and she complained about how difficult it was to protect your intellectual property. Now, I don't want to argue with any artist or publisher about protecting their intellectual property. I believe in that. But I also understood when I came to YouTube in 2010 that a great deal of YouTube had been based on the fact that people were doing exactly what I do, performing popular songs and posting them. Now, the problem is this. As an artist now that has, I've almost been on for 10 years, I have 2,500 songs on YouTube, and I recently received my third copyright strike. It's due to expire in 5 days. They only last for 90 days. But I sit here at the time that I got the first one, I was worried about my 800 songs on YouTube, that I'd lose them if they took my account away. Well, now I've got 2,500. And out of the blue, I get a copyright strike over Tequila Sunrise, which had a cup I have had a cover of that on YouTube for many years, and I had just done another cover of it, and they flagged and pulled the most recent one. So the one that I'd had on there for 5 years or more, nothing. Same thing with Grandma Got Run Over. I look on YouTube and there's all kinds of other covers of that song. Why did mine get picked on? I don't know. And that's the whole problem with YouTube. They want to give you a copyright strike as if it's a punishment. It's no punishment. There's millions and millions and millions of people who do exactly what I do every day. And from my experience, most publishers and artists and copyright owners are more than willing to share their revenue for ads. It's only a few that insist on removing your cover arbitrarily. I mean, if they're going to remove my cover, they darn well better remove everyone. Otherwise, it's discrimination. And I just think it's wrong. I think it's wrong for them to punish, because copyright strikes don't really punish. Well, sure, you shut down my channel, that's punishment, all right. But do you think one copyright strike, what am I going to do? I've got 2,500 songs out there. At any time, any one of these copyright owners could decide, well, I don't want that on YouTube. Now, do they ask me to take it off? No, I'd be happy to do that. I'd be glad to do that. But no, they go to YouTube and say, pull that video. And then YouTube gives me a strike. And so I sit here exposed. If I get 3 strikes in 90 days, poof, my account's gone. And try to talk to YouTube? They won't talk to you. They'll send you a bunch of boilerplate lawyer language that covers their own butts. They'll say things like, well, you know, why don't you write your own song? Why don't you perform your own material? When millions of people, and hey, look, I'm not taking my album of the Eagles' greatest hits and ripping a song and uploading it to YouTube and posting a few photos in the video. I mean, to me, that's wrong. Now, granted, I wouldn't be able to benefit by learning so many songs if people hadn't done that. But look, I'm an artist. Yeah, you can say what you want about my art. Maybe you like my singing and playing. Maybe you don't. But I just think it's ridiculous. Now, let me explain a little bit about what I know about copyright strikes, because George asked me a lot of questions, and I'm going to try to cover those for you. When a copyright owner requests that your song be taken down, it is immediately removed from YouTube, and they will never put it back up. You get a copyright strike. Copyright strikes last for 90 days, then they expire. If you get 3 in 90 days, YouTube says your account may be suspended. Well, believe me, folks, may is enough for me. Now, with 2,500 songs out there, it seems like a pretty good chance that I might get 2 or 3 in a 90-day period. And as I've said before, you can try all you want to get a human response out of YouTube or Google. I've tried. I get nothing. I get nothing but boilerplate. My second copyright strike was for Runaround Sue from Dion. I immediately deleted all my other Dion songs. And when I got the strike for a Tequila Sunrise, I immediately deleted all my Eagles covers, whether or not they wrote them. I don't want to risk it. I mean, there are other artists like Prince. Well, I don't ever have any interest in covering Prince, but I know some of my friends do. They say don't, because his folks will issue you a strike. So strikes, you cannot remove a strike by deleting the video, because once they take it off, it's gone. There's nothing for you to delete. Well, there's a little evidence that it once existed and that it was pulled, but that's all. So you can't get rid of it by deleting it. I've never had any luck trying to ask a publisher, try to get a hold of an address for a music publisher. They don't have time to deal with us. So essentially, YouTube's philosophy is, we will basically try to protect ourselves. And for those of you that do what I do, and that's why I'm doing this, because I strum and play the guitar. Oh, once in a while, I'll add a drum machine. I'll add a harmonizer. I'll maybe play a mandolin in the background or whatever. But essentially, I'm a live artist. And I mean, I can see where the copyright laws for people that are using music to play while they're showing some other videos, that's a totally different situation. So it's trying to get back to this video. As I tried to say, and I hope I don't repeat myself too much, my second copyright strike was for Runaround Sue from Dion. And as I said, I deleted all my other Dion covers, and I subsequently deleted all my other Eagles covers. There is some question about whether a song like Please Come Home for Christmas, which was written by Charles Brown, and I'm probably going to be recording that one again soon. I don't think the Eagles own it, so I'm not as worried about it. But typically, when I'm a little bit leery about Bob Seger songs. If you go on ultimateguitar.com, you'll notice that all of the charts for Bob Seger songs that have been submitted by users have been blocked because his folks don't want they're protecting their copyright that way. Please understand, and I repeat, my intention is not to say that I want to get around copyright laws. I want to comply. But I think that YouTube's position for those of us who do what I do is just simply wrong. Copyright strikes serve no punitive purpose. They're not going to stop me from covering songs that other people own. Now, if YouTube wants to provide a decent database of songs and to tell you whether they're permitted or not, that'd be wonderful. I'd comply. I wouldn't cover something. I'd look it up. But they basically we're left to our to the vagaries of publishers. So if you have other copyright questions, I've truly tried to answer as many of them as I can. How copyright strikes work. Try to go over the things that George and I have been going back and forth on YouTube. And I wish you all well and look forward to some Christmas. It's December 3rd, so I'll be in Christmas mode, probably redoing some of my old Christmas favorites. So I look forward to seeing you again here on YouTube soon. And as always, thanks for the view.